those in favour of this?
Subject to conditions.
And those against? Okay, so after that, the application at SEABANK ROAD, Penkett ROAD has been approved. I now go to 4 with all the conditions listed in the reports. Thank you for that. We now move to agenda item number 9, which is former Lloyds, Davies Bank, Prenton Road, New Ferry. The officer will give us a presentation.
Thank you, Chair, for you, Chair. This application to refer to the planning committee as there are 23 objections to the proposal and 8 letters of support. The application site is a vacant two-storey bank building in the New Ferry Key Town Centre. The northwest of the site is a primary residential area, the dwelling is located 20 metres from the application site. The applications for a change of use from a bank to a public house. The proposed hours of operation are 11 a.m. to 23:30, Monday to Sunday. Objections to the application relate to the creation of a further public house in the area and the detrimental impact that this will have on the vitality of the town centre. There are 2 pubs with it in Wirral Road, and the closest is 138 metres to the north of the site. The proposal will bring a vacant unit back into use, which is considered appropriate within the town centre location and will contribute to the vitality and vibrance of this town centre location. In regards to amenity, usable policy HS1 supports such proposals in the town centre, providing such uses do not lead to loss of amenity in terms of noise and general disturbance. In order to address the concerns raised in relation to this application, a smoking shelter is proposed at to the rear of the property, close to residential properties. The smoking shelter is now being removed from the proposal and a condition attached restricting the use of the rear yard. The adjoining property has flats within the open floors and the conditions proposed restricting any music being played in these rooms that share all the hall of residential units. Many of the objections relate to the proposed vacant opening, and the applicants agreed to reduce these hours from the original submission to 11 a.m. to 11:30 Monday to Sunday. Environmental Protection did not raise any objections to the proposal, and for these reasons, it recommended for approval subject to the attached conditions.
Here's the ward councillor for this
one. I'm supporting the application.
There is no petition against it.
That's what we're told, you see, I was told it's a petition.
We would normally, no, there's letters of objection. In the absence of a petition, we wouldn't normally take further
consideration. I own the Will Hotel, which is the pub across the way.
Okay. So we can't take further. The facts are in the report, and I'll open it to members. Open it to members and for comments.
Thank you, Chair. The only concern I've got is with the smoking. You know, they're restricting the smoking on the site, aren't they? Is there going to be any facility for smokers doing that on the site?
No, there's no, the proposal's to include a smoking shelter at the rear in the rear yard. That's close to, too close to residential properties, so it's been removed from the scheme and there's no other proposed smoking area, dedicated smoking area.
Thank you. actually beg your pardon, that's not been brought to my attention, but I'll certainly bring that forward. Members, of agenda item 13. Agenda item 13, due preservation order.
Thank you, Chair. Thank you, Chair. The purpose of this report is to inform members of an objection to the TPO and to recommend that the order is confirmed. An objection has been received on behalf of the golf club where a planning application has been submitted for development of part of that site. The objections contained within this report are refuted by the Council's tree officer and it's recommended that the Planning Committee approve the TPO despite objections.
Okay, the World Council, what's up?
Thanks, Chair. Thank you. Back again. Thank you. Another TPO, I'm representing, obviously, our World Councils for Bebington. This application has such a significant impact on Bebington Ward, in particular Stanley Avenue. The area has a large amount of trees and fauna and is a haven for wildlife. These areas are being seriously threatened across Wirral, as we all know, by developers. Major notice that this is a conservation area. TPOs are now great significance as we as a council would declare the climate emergency. But far more seriously, Wirral now does not have enough tree cover to cope with pollution. And major tree diseases will cause further damage to the earlier trees on Wirral. The MPDF states development resulting in the loss of deterioration of irreplaceable habitats such as ancient woodland, aged or veteran trees should be refused unless there are exceptional reasons and a suitable compensation strategy. Exceptional reasons are only nationally significant infrastructure projects, and I support this TPO. Thank you.
Thank you very much.
It's not In addition, the house will provide cross funding for the sixth floor block. The applicant was accompanied by a flood risk assessment, and there were no objections to the proposal from the environment agency or the local flood authority, subject to the attached conditions. In terms of residential needs, the proposal meets all the required interface distances, and there's a provision for off-street parking within each housing unit, and there are no objections on housing grounds. For these reasons, the proposed recommended approval, subject to the attached conditions, 106 agreements and referral to the Secretary of State as there was an objection from supporting the matter.
Thank you. Open to members for the petition.
Thanks, Chair. Just for clarification, so we're going to include the section 6, the agreement and the written conditions.
Yes, subject to
106
agreements.
Yeah, we have a sense of two of them, one for the playfields and one for affordable housing as a community center. Any other contributions? Okay, I'll move back beside you.
Sorry, I just wanted to clarify, what was the sum for the four cars?
It's 360,000 pounds.
Have we got that in the paperwork, have we?
It will be as part of 106, yes.
Right. The off-site elements, just so there's a bit of a loud authority before, if we'd insisted on-site, it would be five houses. So from the petitioner's presence.
My name's Charles Barnes from West Kirby. This planning application for the development on top of Grange Hill around the memorial site. Over 100 petitioners and 24 individual objectors to this planning application are in no way intending to be disrespectful to those whose names are remembered on West Kirby War Memorial. However, Grange Hill, including the War Memorial area, is a site of biological importance with several protected species living there. It is also listed as originally important geological site. Therefore, this proposal, with all the building work involved, has a much bigger impact than, say, it would have on Hampton Square War Memorial. Objections to this proposal for the installation of LED lighting on top of Grange Hill centre on the following issues. Condition 4 clearly states that lighting would now be permitted for the month of November. However, 1. The effect of seasonal change on delayed hibernation of bats could still forage on warm November days. Merseyside Bat Group and a local ranger have confirmed this, so we urge the applicant Wirral Council to only light the War Memorial the few days before and after Remembrance Sunday, as it is illuminated in the present ways, not the whole of November. 2. Condition 3 says that details of the lighting and the technical report should be submitted before the installation. This has not happened. We believe a decision cannot be made without those facts to be known, and to enable a fair and proper assessment of this part of the application. The proposed LED lights will cause much more light pollution than traditional light beam that is usually used. Condition 5 shows the risks even MEAS acknowledges for wildlife through building work by requesting several protective measures. The objectors are, however, not reassured that the badgers, especially lizards, etc., will remain unharmed. Hence, Wirral Council are not complying with the policies. Policy NC5, the protection of sites of local importance for nature conservation. Policy NC7, species protection. Policy NC10, the protection of sites of importance for earth science. The objections to the proposed CCTV. If the Home Office Code of Conduct states that CCTV must always meet an identified pressing need, this is no pressing need for CCTV on Grange Hill. Recent crime statistics for West Kirby and daily visits by several objectors show that ASB of crime on Grange Hill is minimal compared to the increase of crime in West Kirby town centre itself. The area around the War Memorial hasn't been a hotspot and has never really been a hotspot for ASB and crime. We were also informed that installing CCTV as a presentation just in case it could become a hotspot in the future. This is not justified. The community representative of the previous problem solving group also confirmed that several police officers, ASB team and youth service do not think that the CCTV would work as a deterrent, as can be seen with West Kirby Town Centre, which is very well lit and has several CCTVs. Dog walkers and visitors are the best protective measures on this. Point 3.1 and 4 in the report acknowledges that the applicant has not replied to the question who will have access to the images and who will administer the CCTV, for how long the images will be stored as per stipulation by the Data Protection Act. This needs to be known before any permission is granted. There is no reassurance that the camera will be operated by trained WBC staff. Therefore, the concerns of misuse are very valid. It is acknowledged that some people might want to participate in commemorative events via webcam. This is the objection to the webcam. However, These services normally happen once a year. With modern technology, these events can be filmed and even live streamed, put on YouTube, Facebook or website from Friends of Grange Hill. An intensive-looking poll and intrusive-looking poll, people are subjected to 24/7 live streaming on this peaceful site of reflection and remembrance do not justify the installation. We also know of veterans who physically go to the war memorial but have recorded it to council that they won't stop going. That is, they were to be viewed virtually whilst in painful memory. Safety issues, spying on people by accessing public webcams through mobile phones is quite common. We know the petitions would feel much less safe with camera than without. Building work again, excavation work for the webcam would damage the sandstone, put protected species at risk. We haven't seen the proposal being approved by a qualified geologist to preserve the risk status of Grange Hill. Conclusion, I would like the planning committee to reject this planning. We would like the planning committee to reject this planning application based on all the above points whereby breaches of council's own policies and legal duties could happen. NC5, NC7, NC10, as previously detailed, the precautionary principle must be adhered to in this whole application. Alternative ways of promoting the site, we have already stated in detail. Please consider alternative ways. The site actually had a relatively recent survey done, a biodiversity survey several years ago, lists 78 plus species of flowering plants, 19 species of insects, plus various species of protected reptiles and birds, some of which are scarce, nearly extinct in parts of the UK in this environmental crisis we are now in, where our green areas and environmental spaces are so much under threat. The council, the committee, the local people, we all have a duty to protect what we've got left. Thank you.
Thank you. Any members have any questions? Okay, thank you very much. Is there a representative for the applicant?
Mr. Chairman, I'm not a representative of the applicant, but I am the chairman of Friends of Grange Hill, who will be funding
You're able to speak on behalf of the applicant.
I'd like to, if that's permissible.
Okay. That's fine. Right.
The phone is switched off. Can you hear me right?
I can certainly hear you. Introduce yourself again for the mic, and then we have 5 minutes, and I'll give you 1 minute welcome.
Mr. Chairman, councillors, I am Derek Longman. I am chairman of Friends of Grange Hill. We were set up in 2012 by a public meeting with the aims of actually improving Grange Hill and its environment. Our work has included clearance of invasive species, such as the rhododendron and laurel, which is a great threat to the lowland heath that is the designation of Grange Hill. We commenced that work in 2012-2013, and the year after we cleared a lot of the rhododendron on Grange Hill, one of the protected species, which is basically hunted by certain groups and who wish to control its spread, that set up a home on Grange Hill. I'm careful of how I describe that and because it's not advisable to actually mention it, what type of animal it is, but I think you would be wise enough to understand that. We actually do as much as we can to encourage the diversity of Grange Hill, as I say, Grange Hill is a lowland heath and we're not there just purely for one particular species or plant life. Sadly, Grange Hill suffers a lot of arson attacks and damage to its great war memorial. In fact, one of the things that the soldier statue, which was designed by Charles Sergeant Jagger, should have a bayonet permanently attached to it. Unfortunately, because because of vandalism over many, many years, that can never be put on the permit. It's actually only put on the Sunday, Remembrance Sunday, and it's taken down. As I say, Grange Hill suffers vandalism and arson attacks, so does the War Memorial. A survey conducted by Donald Elson, points out there are a number of the letters of the names missing and the legends that are all on the War Memorial, and these all need replacing. It's through the Friends of Grange Hill and its supporters that we have been able to secure such good funds for Grange Hill and the War Memorial. We believe that the webcam facility will actually have twofold. It's not a designated CCTV, it's a webcam. It will allow people to visit Grange Hill via the internet. It will also allow people to visit it and see its wildlife. The current designation for Grange Hill is a local wildlife site, not an SBI, that's the up-to-date designation for us. Roots, I'm not a qualified geologist, but I can guarantee from what I've understood from past workings with rigs is that it will not be detrimental to its rigs designation. It's the vertical faces and it's the contact between the Cooper and Bunter sandstone rocks that are actually make it such a site of regionally important geomorphological site. Moving back on to the lighting which we want to install, that will replace the out-of-date sodium lighting, which I believe is something like a 500-watt system, which illuminates the War Memorial for a good part of November, dependent on when the contractors can actually put the lighting up and when they can take it down. The LED system that will be put in its place will be far more carbon neutral than that that is currently in place. Do you want to keep...
No.
Sorry. Yeah. We know we have great support in the community. We know there are people objecting to what we propose. Sadly, there's a lot of those people that object to absolutely everything we do. Also, one of the objectors, I'm not saying it's one of these people here tonight, but has actually sabotaged the War Memorial, the Garden of Remembrance, on other occasions, particularly on Remembrance Sunday. We have photographic evidence. I have other people who can speak up and confirm this. I would recommend that the new lighting proposal pass. I also recommend that because of the fantastic views of the Grange Hill has to offer, and we have expats living elsewhere who still want to visit the site, they can do so by the webcam facility, and that webcam facility will have a recall system so that if anything untoward goes on there, it can be handed over to the security. It's mainly for the landscaping, because of the topography of the hill, it can't actually look into people's homes and houses. If it's going to actually record an image of plants and wildlife, then surely it will capture images of people walking them out.
Okay, thank you. Okay, we'll come to
lights in the evening.
for the wildlife. I mean, this was one of the reasons that we deferred a decision from the last meeting on paragraph 2.2, page 31. You know, we've consulted with MEOLS, who are the environment consultancy. Natural regulators have no objection. And the objection that was brought forward from Wirral Wildlife concerned past activity between April and October, and that was the point. We had some concerns about all the environment lighting, which was the original proposal. That's obviously now been modified, and I assume that objection then has been satisfied. So that to be made no other objection to us in terms of other issues with the lighting. Any other comments? Okay, I think we have to take them one at a time, so we'll begin with agenda item 4, which is the planning permission one. I'll move the recommendation, if there's a second. Let's see those in favour. And those against? And now agenda item 5, which is the listed building consent. Can I see those in favour? You seconded that one as well?
Yeah.
And those against? Okay, is there abstention? Thank you. Okay, so I'm just coming here for item 4. That application has been approved, and linked to that, agenda item 5. That application has been approved. Moving on to agenda item number 7, the cleared size Beaufort Road Beckenhead. The planning officer recorded the presentation.
So permission is sought for the erection of 178 new dwellings. The site is brownfield and housing once occupied the site before being demolished. There are 11 different house types and are a mix of detached and semi-detached properties. This will provide some variety across the development. Off-street parking and private gardens are provided for each property. The local highway network can accommodate the proposed development safely, and it is not considered the proposal to impact negatively on the roundabout junction of both the road and Wallasey Bridge Road, or the signal junctions around St James's Church. Mitigation measures around the potential for increased recreational pressure to protected sites as a result of an increase in local population have been secured, and Habitat's regulations assessment has concluded that there will be no adverse impact on protected sites as a result of these measures being taken in place. The proposed development will bring the vacant brownfield site back into use, which will have a positive impact on the area and contribute considerably to meeting an identified housing need. Proposals are recommended for approval, and there is no petition in association with this application.
Okay, thanks for that. It's for us because it's classed from the scheme of delegation as a major development. Are there any comments from others? This is indeed a brownfield site where there used to be houses, and the process of houses on it. I'll just say to the committee, if I may, that it's before us because it exceeds our lower threshold. In the scheme of delegation, our lower threshold is 50 houses, and it strikes me that that's too low. I don't think anybody around the table has any objections to it. To raise any objections to proposing a consultation with party groups to revisit the scheme of delegation, this sort of application ought to have been approved without without the undue delay, but the fact that the tatter comes to the committee has given it, because I think as we rest the brownfield sites, obviously a strong record, we'll want them to be approved as swiftly as possible and progress well. So I'll just raise that, but I can expect another email from me consulting on the scheme delegation. Steve from that name.
Yeah, just a quick comment. I welcome the scheme and everything like that. I'm just a bit disappointed in the sort of town climate emergency that there's plenty, to me, excessive car parking spaces when there's a station up the road. And it's just a comment that I just feel that we should try and reduce car parking and encourage people to go on to public transport rather than sort of have mass parking for many, many lessons.
Just one point
from
the
Chair.
The planning office, has there been any representation from the cellar occupants left on the site?
I suppose it.
Just curious, really, you know, four people have lived there, which are down in sight for junkies years, and refused to put it, so presumably they're quite happy with this.
Yeah.
And so it's approved by the moment. Okay, then I will move approval.